considered this man to be one of the greatest evangelists in the, I think he said, the 20th century. He got 20th century. And so, this is what Billy Graham said about the Southern Baptist Convention's efforts to convert non-Christians, and by that I mean most of the Jews, including whoever. This is what he said. He made this statement. He said, I have never targeted Muslims. I have never targeted Jews. I believe that we should declare the fact that God loves you, God will forgive you, God can change you, and Christ and His kingdom is open to anybody who repents and by faith receives Him as Lord and Savior. So, He never targets Muslims. He never targets Jews. He's not going to really emphasize converting anybody to Christianity. So, let me ask this. Why does it bother you if our nation starts becoming less of a Christian nation and starts becoming a Muslim nation, or a woman, or a Buddhist nation, or a Hindu nation, or an atheist nation? Why does it bother you? The so-called, now this is one of my term, the greatest evangelist in the 20th century, say he is not concerned about converting non-Christians, and he actually opposes the convention of the denomination in the party of the Southern Baptist Convention. And yet this great evangelist, this God among men, this Christ incarnate, I guess if you listen to some of it, he is not in favor of converting non-Christians. So what of your friends, does it disturb you? Does it bother you? Does it affect you? And why do people start whining, moaning, grumbling, complaining? I say, well, I don't like to hear people say we're not a Christian nation. We are a Christian nation. Why are you complaining? You know, the man that you hold up and hold up as one of the greatest evangelists of all time says, I'm not really concerned. I don't really target these non-Christian individuals. I say, God loves you. Christ's kingdom is open. You come to join if you want to. Well, does it really surprise you then that, we are leaving any semblance of a Christian nation we had and we're going to another kind of nation? Does it really surprise you? See, this is what we're talking about, friends. As a society, we have become so unconcerned about the Scripture. We've become so uninterested in what God would have to say for our society that the only thing, only because we seem to have, is we have to go and groan and complain and say, oh, we're a Christian nation, and we whine and whine and whine. You know, the president might have invited the Muslims and the Baptists and the Methodists and the Pentecostals and the Hindus and the whoever they all come to the White House and we're gonna all get together and have a prayer. What would they do anyway? You don't believe that it matters anyway. Okay? This is what we're talking about. We're talking about individuals who are struggling with it. You can't have it both ways. You can't have it both ways. You can't say, on one hand, we're a Christian nation. And don't you dare say anything different about the United States of America. And then on the other hand, say, well, you can't judge people's beliefs. But if I had a dime for every time I have someone come over here and say, you can't be judging me, man, I would be a rich man. I would be worried about the economy. I'd have to hold stock up. But you people are saying, well, we're a Christian nation. destination. You want this to be a good station, then you want to start becoming a Christian. You got to start talking like a Christian, teaching like a Christian, following Christ like a Christian would. Supporting the things we used to, we wouldn't touch with a 10-foot pole. concerned that if someone like a preacher got up and started preaching against me, like homosexuality, they could actually cause that person, that preacher, to be guilty of a crime simply by opposing that lifestyle. Now, the language of this bill, listen, the language of this bill, this bill is passed in the House, in the Congress. Listen, it says, the state Congress will make 30 sexual orientations federally protected. The American Psychiatric Association has published 30 such sexual orientations that because of Congress's refusal to define sexual orientation will be protected under this legislation. In other words, they issue the term, we're going to protect sexually oriented, or certain sexually orientations that will be protected under the federal law. And if someone speaks badly about someone who is oriented in such a way, Congressman Stephen King, Republican of Ohio, said, told Democratic members,